I think, Larry, as I said, Larry became an autobiographical character. He
Yeah.
became me, and I'm very much him. He, I think, doesn't belong as I didn't belong. He doesn't really have friends. He doesn't seem to fit in the area where he lives. In fact, that the only person he really talks to is his mother, and she's forgotten him. So he's absolutely by himself. So he doesn't belong, I think, to the community, or he's apart from the community. He's a pariah in the community. In a way, Silas doesn't belong because he, was popular there, but left and comes back to damage that he's done. I think Wallace Stringfellow, in his way, doesn't belong. Now, he is, I think, desperately seeking attention and company. I mean, he identifies with this man that he thinks killed two women. And part of him, there's some sick parts of him. And he identifies with Larry and tries to make a friendship there. And that's, in fact, a very poisoned friendship. But it's Larry's only friendship. And in fact, the saddest parts of the book, I think, is Larry's only Christmas present, which is a pistol from Wallace. And that's the best thing Wallace can think of to give Larry. So there's real kindness there mixed in with the cruelty and the pathology of this Wallace character. So I see, those three main characters, I see none of them quite fitting in and trying in their own ways to belong. Wallace trying to belong with Larry. Larry trying to belong anywhere. Silas trying to get his way back in.